In today's time, infertility is very much common. You can say out of 100 couples, 60 are facing this problem, mainly because of the lifestyle. It has become a lifestyle disease now. Because these days, both couples are working, they have so much work pressure, so much house pressure, so they delay the decision of having kids according to age. So biological clock is ticking, 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 and the more the age, the difficult it becomes. Plus, there is a very big occurrence of hypothyroidism in females these days. It's one of the major causes of infertility. There are no other symptoms and patient has never thought about ki mujhe thyroid bhi ho sakta because nobody in my family has it. But the main complaint they present to doctor is infertility. They are not able to conceive, and when we go through blood works, there is hypothyroidism in the background. Plus, another most important cause is PCOS, in which multiple cysts are formed inside the ovary. The follicles grow but they don't rupture and the cysts are formed. So this is another very important cause. And plus, weight gain, excessive weight gain slows down the hormonal regulation and again the follicle is not formed. Lifestyle diseases, blood pressure, diabetes, smoking, alcohol, all these are contributed towards infertility. Now how do we treat it in homeopathy? In homeopathy, we go through a proper case-taking, elaborate case-taking, case-taking not only of the patient but also of the partner, how they live, what is the lifestyle they are using, what are the things they are doing, what are other complaints associated. So, making a whole sort of picture, it becomes clear ki what could be the probable cause. Now, the treatment starts with counseling, first of all. We motivate the patient to make healthy changes in diet, lose weight, take small meals, go for walks, do yoga. Plus, we also teach them few techniques, short techniques of silent sitting, positive thinking. We try to sort of ignite their internal system to think about them, to make changes for the health. This is how we do. Of course, medicines are given, but patient has to be healthy even without medicines. Health has to be sustained, not just delivered through medicines.